Dear students, today we will learn turbines and impulse turbines chapter. It is the second module of the second portion of the module 4 now. So the syllabus for this second part is introduction to turbine, general layout of hydroelectric plant, heads and efficiencies, classification of turbines, belt and wheel components, working principle of velocity triangles, maximum power efficiency, working proportions, and numerical problems. This chapter follows in module 5 with two other turbines, that is Francis turbines and the Keplon turbine, which comes under module 5 now. After going through this second part of the turbine chapter, you will be understanding the components of hydroelectric power plants, turbines, types of turbines and their classification, working principle of the belt and wheel, and the design of the belt and wheel now. Now today in this class, we will learn about the introduction of the turbines, general layout of the hydroelectric power plants and the components and its components and the functions of each of the components now. So as the name itself indicates, the power generation with the water as the media is called as the hydropower. It is one of the most economic power generation technique. The other types of power generation may be what you may be knowing is the thermal power, the wind power. This is a non-polluting source of energy. So if you think of a thermal power, you will be having the burning of the coal will be there now. Therefore, the pollution because of the carbon dioxide emission and the fly ash emission will be there in the case of thermal power. However, in the case of wind power, although it is considered to be renewable, the cost of wind power installation is very costly, and we have to wait for the wind for the power generation, and it is location specific. You cannot generate the wind power unless sufficient wind speed is available at a particular station, even though wind mills have been established at that location. So this power generated from water is known as hydroelectricity. It is possible by storing the water in the reservoir and creating sufficient head for the power generation. So hydroelectricity power generation will be done by means of storing the water in the reservoir and creating the potential head, and that potential energy head is converted into kinetic energy by means of making the water to flow through gravity to the lower level and creating higher velocity, and this velocity energy will in turn rotate the turbine and the shaft of the turbine, and which is being coupled to the generator, and the electric power will be get generated. So the hydraulic turbine, what you are seeing, it consists of a runner which is fixed to the shaft. The main aim of hydropower generation, hydropower, is to rotate the shaft. So if sufficient rotation is made, then it is possible to generate, sufficient power now. So here the main aim of this hydropower generation is to see that sufficient rotation shall be made possible by creating potential energy. Or if you are having sufficient head availability, we will store the water in the reservoir, and that water is being utilized for rotation of the turbine. So the shaft is connected to the generator. The shaft of the turbine generates what is known as the mechanical energy, not the electrical energy. So that means whenever a hydroelectric power plant is there, you should have a turbine as well as you should have a generator. Generator is a different machine which converts the mechanical energy to the electrical energy now. So hydropower plant, if you are thinking, you should have the turbine as well as the generator. That should be known to you. So here, if you are thinking of the power generation in India, if you are thinking how much water power that can be generated in India, if you want to know, it is about 80,000 megawatts. It is being estimated that 80,000 megawatts of power can be exploited with the quantum of water and with the quantum of availability of the water resources as well as the site condition. However, this is not being made because the first one is sufficient, the construction of dam is a difficult topic because we have to take the clearance from various agencies. These various agencies comprise of the environmental clearance. This environmental clearance comprise of, we should not destroy any forest now. But when we want to construct a dam, we may have to see that this forest wealth we have to lose. This is one of the resources, this forest wealth we have to lose. And also we have to see that we may lose certain amount of flora and fauna, and also some amount of, whenever we construct a dam, some areas may be get submerged, submergence may be, the fertile lands may be get submerged, or you may see that some urban area or the villages may be get submerged. When these things are submerged, we may have to rehabilitation. So rehabilitation problem, one thing. Second one is we will be losing the forest wealth, and also we will be having the problem of losing of this flora and fauna. So the hence construction of reservoir is becoming a problem. Therefore, the extent of power that can be generated from the water is not possible or is not being taken up by the governments, and hence we are yet to see that What are the alternatives for the electrical power generation? So the cost of 1 megawatt of power, it is being estimated that about 4 crores. Of course, this cost may be more, but when compared to the maintenance of a thermal power plant or the wind power plant, this is almost nil. The maintenance of hydropower plant is almost nil. So this cost can be made up after certain life of the reservoir. After certain life of the reservoir, maybe after about 20 to 25 years of 20 to 25 years of dam construction, this cost can be shattered up. So the cost may not be a criteria for not construction of a dam. The criteria may be, it is what I told you, it may be the environmental cost, it may be the rehabilitation cost, it may be the other cause, that may be interstate problem. All these things might not may be seeing that we are unable to construct a dam now. Even in Karnataka, we have a good hydrological pattern, sites are good, topography is good, and we have technology is also available. So we can harness large amount of hydropower. The hydropower potential of Karnataka is about 7,000 megawatts, of which already 6,498 megawatts is being harnessed. So we are in par with good hydropower generation now. And also small power plants, mini power plants are under constructions, and we are harnessing the hydropower to the maximum extent now. So Karnataka is one of the top state where hydropower is being generated in India. Now let us see the various components of hydropower plants now. So the hydropower plant, as you can see here now, you should have a reservoir now. The reservoir is nothing but a dam, and the head is to be created now. This is called as the head H. This is called as the head H. That is from the center of penstock. Penstock to the reservoir level at any time is called as the head. This is also called as the potential head. This is also called as the potential head now. This head, the static head, this is also called as the static head. Static head is converted into kinetic head or kinetic energy by means of allowing the water, by means of conveying the water through the penstock in a gradient. So that means you should have a difference in level. You should have a difference in level between the center of the penstock and the center of this one. This is called as the head that is being responsible for the generation of this kinetic head. Of course, we will be seeing what is the net head afterwards now. So the velocity energy, the static energy will be converted into velocity energy. The static energy is also called as the potential energy, is converted into velocity energy in the penstock, and it makes the rotation of the shaft now. Rotation of the runner. First of all, we have to say it as the runner. Runner will be rotated. This runner rotation as rudder is connected to the shaft, shaft is being rotated now. The shaft is coupled to the generator and the generator rotates. Generator will have the rotor and stator now. So more about it we'll be seeing in the next slides now. So that means here, that means whenever we want to generate the power, you should have a dam where the water can be stored and it can be controlled. The water entry into the penstock can be controlled, how much of water that has to be passed, or you may have to stop at a certain time, means it is possible, or you want to store the water for certain amount of time, means yes, it is possible. That is why it is called as the dam. It is also called as the forebay. It is also called as the forebay in some cases now. An intake should be there. What is this intake? We will be looking at in the next slides now. The penstock carries the water into the turbine and increases the velocity, and hence it is the kinetic energy. What is? It is a medium where potential energy is converted into kinetic energy in the penstock. Then you are having an inlet valve now. When we open this inlet valve, the water enters into the turbine chamber. The turbine rotates now. The water force acting on the blades turn the turbine now. So after the turbine is being rotated, this turbine shaft is connected to the generator. Generator also rotates. It is having two components. One is called as the rotor. Another one is called as the stator. What are the function of rotor and stator? We shall see now. The water after running the turbine will return to the tail race. It is also called as the river proper or nala proper, from where the water is. This is also called as the tail race, and this water can be reutilized for some useful purpose. This useful purpose may be irrigation, or it may be industries or water supply, whatsoever it may be. They are some of the components of hydropower plant. So how the conversion, if you look into the plan of plan of the hydroelectric power plant. So a dam is being constructed here now. It is also called the reservoir now. The reservoir will get formed whenever a dam is constructed. Dam is not called the reservoir. Dam is nothing but a barrier. It is a barrier. Dam is nothing but a barrier now. This barrier creates what is known as the reservoir. So this reservoir is being connected to the penstock through a sluice gate or an intake, and an inlet valve will be there here now, which allows the water to the turbine, and after the rotation of the turbine it flows to the river proper through the draft tube and the tail race now. This turbine is being connected to the generator, and the generator will generate the power supply. That's how these are the main components of the turbine now. So how the energy conversion happens, I have already told you now. It is the potential energy which is stored in the water. So it is nothing but, it is the height from the center of the penstock to the reservoir level at any time. This is called the potential energy. This potential energy will be converted into kinetic energy, because there is a difference in the level, increases the velocity, and it will convert potential energy will be converted into velocity energy, which is nothing but V squared by 2G. Okay, so that is the kinetic energy. So this kinetic energy makes rotation of the shaft here now. This rotation of the shaft is nothing but the mechanical energy. It is also called as the shaft power. shaft power. Shaft power. So what I am putting you here is the water power. The input is the water power. Input is water power. Output is nothing but the shaft power. This is the output. This shaft power, this shaft rotation is coupled to the generator, and generator is having, as I have already told you, rotor and stator. Rotor and stator, it converts it into electrical energy. So how many energies comes into picture in this system? One is the potential energy, second one is the kinetic energy, water falling from a height, it is kinetic energy. Third one is the mechanical energy, that is the rotation of the shaft. Fourth one is the electrical energy, it is through the generator. So energy conversion mechanism is having four types of energy now. Now, how the things will be shown? This is a pictorial view of a reservoir. It consists of four penstock, as you can see in the picture now. This four penstock, each penstock should have one turbine, is connected to one turbine. That is important. One penstock, one turbine. That means in this picture, four penstock, four turbines are there now. So, type of turbine, we will look into it now. What type of turbine now? This is called as the powerhouse now. This is called as the powerhouse. This turbine and the generator are housed in this powerhouse now. After the rotation of the turbine, the water will be led back to the tail race. This is called as the tail race. The tail race may be directly a river, or you may construct a canal and it may go through it, or you may have pipes also. Through the pipes also the water may lead to the river proper after conversion of the energy. So this is a dam powerhouse what you are seeing. So the various components, as you can see here now, four bay, intake structure, penstock, surge chamber, hydraulic turbines, powerhouse, draft tube and tail race. This powerhouse comprises of turbine and generator. These are the two components that will be there in the powerhouse. Now, these two are there. So turbine is also there in the powerhouse only now. So now one by one we shall look at it, what are these things now. So four bay, it is nothing but, it is the place where we store the water. Store the water and lead the water to intake. What is intake? We will look at it now. So that means here it is a place, it controls the water to turbine. It controls the water to turbine now. So as per the load requirement, for example, if you don't want to generate the power on a particular period, if I stop the turbine, water flow to the turbine, then it will store the water now. Storing is possible now. And also if you require more water, the stored water can be led to the penstock to the turbine. So what is that we can call now? It is nothing but, it is a temporary storage of water. Temporary storage reservoir. So important thing that you want to note it here, So whenever a dam powerhouse is there, what you have seen in the previous picture now, reservoir itself will act as the forebane. This dam, what you are seeing, will itself act as the reservoir. This itself will act as the forebane. That means what? It controls the water to the penstock whenever it is required. It is not required means it will store the water in the reservoir now. So whenever you require large quantity of water also, it is possible to make the water to flow through all the four penstocks. That is possible now. For example, if one turbine is under repair, I don't want to release the water to the turbine, then I will stop the water to the penstock. Under this condition, it stores the water which is required for this purpose also. So whenever you require water to the turbine, the forebay will take care of the quantity of water to the reservoir. So that means a forebay may be a small reservoir which is constructed for only hydropower generation, or a reservoir itself. For example, Tungabhadra dam is there near Hospet. It serves for irrigation as well as it serves for water supply, industries, etc., as well as we are generating the power now. That is a multi-purpose dam. It is a multi-purpose dam now. Okay. So that means here reservoir itself will act as the forebay now. On the other hand, we may have a reservoir which is constructed exclusively for hydropower generation only. For example, Kali project Supa in Karnataka is constructed only for power generation. It is a reservoir as well as a forebay now. Okay. So some dams are constructed only for power generation. Some dams are constructed for multi-purpose now. That should also be understood. So dams will not be constructed only for power generation. It may be used for the irrigation also apart from it now. So it is temporarily stored. For example, in northern India, most of the rivers are perennial. That means what? All throughout the year, you will be having sufficient quantity of water. Under such condition, you may have a small reservoir to create the head. You may construct a small reservoir and which will have sufficient head for the power generation, now. And it may store water only for 1 week, maybe 1 week, or it may be more a fortnight, maybe the storage. But in case of southern India, where we get the rainfall only during July to September, we have to store all round water. All round year we have to store the water. Okay. Therefore, Sharavati reservoir, which acts as the storage reservoir or a forebay for the power generation of Sharavati project now. So it may be, it cannot be called as temporary. It may be a permanent now. In the case of Sharavati dam, it is a permanent. In the case of Supa dam, it is a permanent reservoir which stores the water for complete power generation. Whereas in some reservoir in northern India where the rivers are perennial, we may store it temporarily. So it a temporary storage may also be necessary in those rivers because we want to head up the water. we want to head up the water, and potential head is to be created now. So the storage of head, the storage of how much of storage that should be there, it all depends upon how much of power that you want to generate, how much of head is required for power generation, whether it is in this case or whether it is in this case, whether it is temporary or whether it is permanent, you may have to estimate the quantity of water that is to be stored for the power generation, and you have to estimate the head that is required for the power generation. So that is about this one. Now the reservoir built across the rivers store the water, and the water stored in the upstream side of the dam can be carried through the penstock, what we have shown you here now. So it carried through the penstock here now. It carries through the penstock and it leads to the turbines now. Now this is a four-way. Most probably the picture shows now this is a temporary reservoir. It is not, as you are seeing, this is a permanent one. What you are seeing, it is a permanent one now. Temporary means it stores for complete, most probably for complete season, we can say now. Whereas this reservoir, as you are seeing, it stores for only about maybe 15 days. So generally canal power plants, what we are generating in Karnataka, they are also called as small hydropower plants, or it is also called as mini hydel plants will have a small storage, temporary storage, say about a week or 10 days storage may be there now. Now this four-way is being connected to, the function of the four-way is to store the water and lead it to the intake chamber now. And the function of the four-way, naturally provided storage, is to absorb the flow variation. That means whenever we don't want water, it will store the water. We don't want to generate the power, we store the water. Otherwise, the water will be leading to the turbines now. So, finally, if you want to say about the functions, is functions of the four-way is to store the water when the plant is not working, when the hydropower plant is not working or the turbines are not working, and to release the water to the turbine when the requirement of water is there for the turbine. Now, the four-way leads the water to the intake structure now. The intake structure collects the water from the four-way and directs it to the penstock now. You can see it here. So this is the intake now. Each of these will be leading to the penstock now. Each of these, this is the regulator. It can be opened, the gate can be opened, and the water can be led to the penstock now. So intake will be having the thrash rack also now. What is this thrash rack? We will look into it in the next slide now. So intake is a device which leads the water to the penstock. That is the function of the intake now. So intake is a structure which collects the water from the four-way and directs it into penstock now. Now the next one is thrash rack. So what is a thrash rack? So as you can see in the picture now, thrash rack consists of a mesh here now. It is also called the rack. A mesh consisting of horizontal bars and vertical bars, which will hold the debris. This is called the debris. As well as the mud, if it is there. It will hold the water containing debris and muds, and it filters so that the debris and mud should not enter into the penstock. So the penstock is made of either mild steel or cast iron or concrete. The turbine blades are made of the mild steel. And if at all, if these debris or mud enters into the penstock, it may damage the surface of the penstock, or it may damage the runner blades. Therefore, the water that is entering into the penstock should be free of debris and mud. That is being done by means of not allowing the debris through these trash rack. It filters the water and releases the water to the penstock now. So it is located in between the reservoir and the turbine. Debris along with the water flows into the penstock, may cause severe damage to the turbine runners, nozzles, etc. And hence, we have to see that the water that is leading into the turbine should be free of these debris and the mud. This picture shows how much of water that is there now. This is called the intake. This portion is called the intake now. This is called the intake. And through this intake, the water is entering into the thrash rack now. So that is what we have to understand now. So the next part, here you can see now, this is the penstock now. This is the intake now. From the intake, the water is being passed through the thrash rack now. And it is entering into the penstock. What is the function of the penstock? The function of the penstock is to convert the velocity, convert the head. That is nothing but the potential energy which is there here in the reservoir into kinetic energy. When the water flows through the peristalk through gravity, the velocity increases. Velocity increases in the peristalk, and hence the velocity energy will increase, and that velocity energy is being utilized for the rotation of the runner. So penstock is a pipe. What is this pipe? Pipe may be made of mild steel, cast iron, or it may be made of concrete also. This is the material with which the penstock is generally made up of. So it carries the water from the reservoir to the runner now. So it is the kinetic and the potential energy of water in the penstock decides the amount of power generated. How much of velocity that increases in the penstock is directly proportional to the rotation or the mechanical energy that is being generated from this kinetic energy. So in turn, we can say that how much of velocity that is generated from the penstock is directly proportional to what is the amount of rotation that will create. Rotation of the shaft. Here, rotation of the shaft. Okay. If the velocity is less, the turbine rotation will be less now. If the velocity is more, the turbine rotation will be more, and hence the mechanical energy will be more. That should be understood to you now. So you can see here the penstocks here now. You are having five penstock, and naturally you should have five turbines. You should have five turbines in this case now. You are having two penstock, and naturally you should have two turbines. Two turbines should be there now. And this is called as the powerhouse. tomorrow's, and here you will be having turbine plus generator. Both the things will be there now. The water, after passing through the turbine, it releases to the tail race. It releases to the tail race now. So now, the next component is the surge tank. This is not being told to you now. What is the surge tank? Whenever we want to close down the turbine, the reason may be the repair. Repair of the turbine may come sometime, or maintenance may be there. Maintenance may be there, or you may feel that the turbine is to be closed for some time because we don't have sufficient quantity of water. Whenever we close down the turbine by means of an inlet valve here, as you can see, the inlet valve is being shown to you in the first slide. The inlet valve is here. This is the inlet valve. At this point, you are seeing the inlet valve now. So, if the inlet valve is closed, what is going to happen here is, if the inlet valve is closed, you have already shown that the water hammer effect is going to be the problem now. That means here, if this inlet valve is closed, immediately water will start flowing in the backward direction. This is called as the back pressure. This is our English. But the term what we use in our fluid mechanics is water hammer. What is this water hammer? So water hammer means if sufficient thickness of the pipe is not there for penstock, it may burst because the back pressure that is being get developed. So what we have to see that the pressure that is developed because of the sudden closure of this wall is to be taken up by some component. The component that is there is nothing but our surge tank. So what did this surge tank do? Surge tank, this is the surge tank. What you can see in here is this is the surge tank. This is called as the surge tank now. What is the function of this one? Whenever the water hammer pressure, whenever the pressure increases in sudden closure of the valve, all reduction of flow we have done. The reduction of flow in the penstock may also be done. That is another case now. We may suddenly close or we may reduce the flow of water in the penstock. In any case, the water hammer pressure that is being developed because of the back water flow, it is being controlled by means of rise of water level in the tank now. When the water pressure increases, the water will rise in this surge tank, and hence the reduction in the pressure is going to happen and normal pressure is going to be established. Normal pressure is going to be get established. So what is the function of surge tank? The function of surge tank is to see that always the pressure in the penstock is normal. Whenever due to some reasons, if the pressure rises in the penstock, the water level in the surge tank will increase, and hence the pressure will become normal. So a surge tank is a water storage device used as a pressure neutralizer. It is a pressure neutralizer. That is important. That means it brings to normal pressure. It brings the water to normal pressure in the water conveyance system, means in the penstock. If at all, if there is excess pressure developed, why excess pressure is developed? because of three reasons. Repair of the turbines, maintenance of the turbine, or I want to reduce the load. Reduce the load on the turbine. In all these cases, we may reduce the discharge. Reduce the discharge to the turbine. Whenever you reduce the discharge to the turbine by means of controlling this inlet valve, you have the problem of rise in the water level. Okay, that is being taken care of by means of surge tank. So, surge tank is for the purpose of making the penstock safeguard and works always under safe pressure. Okay, if the turbine loads are to be decreased suddenly, then the gates are controlled and the flow of water in turbine shuts down suddenly, creating huge pressure in the penstock, what I told now. To prevent the penstock from exploding, that means it may break, you know it already, what is water hammer, that you know it now. If it is not properly designed, if the pipe is not properly designed, it may explode. This explosion of this pipe is being get reduced by rising of water in the surge tank. The rise of water in the surge tank creates the penstock to run under normal pressure or design pressure. Design pressure of penstock. Okay, that should be noted. Next one is the turbine. So turbine consists of what? Turbine consists of rudder. So this turbine converts the water power. So water power is nothing but, what is this water power? It is coming from the penstock. It is nothing but kinetic energy. So it is nothing but velocity energy, whatever that is there. That converts into mechanical energy. Mechanical energy. It is nothing but what? Rotation of the shaft. Rotation of shaft of the rudder. That is the main aim. It is also called as shaft power. So many terms are there now. So what we are finally doing? Water power to shaft power. So what is the function of hydraulic turbine? It converts the water power to shaft power. That is what the final inference that we want to say. So in the beginning we say that the velocity energy will convert into mechanical energy. Okay. So it is again converted into electrical energy when it is coupled to the generator. When it is coupled to the generator. Here you can see. So this is the powerhouse. In the powerhouse, how the turbines will be there. For example, here you can see 1, 2, 3, 4 turbines like this. Now, turbines and generator coupling is being kept how it is in the powerhouse, how it looks. That picture is being shown here now. The turbine shaft is being converted into, the turbine shaft is being coupled to the generator now. That we will see it afterwards, tail race we will come now. The turbine shaft is converted into generator now. What is the function of generator? This is the generator now. What is the function of generator? Generator converts shaft power to electrical power. Also, it is also called as the mechanical energy into electrical energy. Or it is also called as the mechanical power to electrical power. Here there is a media. That is nothing but the magnetic power also it is there. Magnetic power is also there. From there, it converts into mechanical power to magnetic power to electrical power. So here, it consists of this generator consists of two components. One is the rotor, another one is the stator. So what rotor comprise of? Rotor comprise of electromagnets. Rotor comprise of electromagnets. This is called as the rotor. Why it is rotor? It rotates. The shaft is connected to the shaft of the turbine is being connected to the rotor of the generator. What rotor consists of? It consists of huge magnets. These are called as the huge magnets. Huge electromagnets will be there now. So when it rotates, when this rotates, here the stator is there now. This is the stator. What stator comprise of? Stator comprise of electrical coils. Electrical copper coils. So it is wound over the stator now. This is being wound over the stator now. So it cuts the magnetic, whenever the rotor rotates, the magnetic energy is being generated. This magnetic energy is being cut by the copper coils and the electrical energy is being generated now. This electrical energy is being, it is nothing but the alternating currents is being connected. This electrical energy is being converted by means of transformer inside the power outs. It converts the AC into higher voltage current. It converts the AC current, alternating current, into higher voltage currents now. Okay. So now, that is the function of the powerhouse now. So this, each turbine will be having the generator and a transformer now. The transformer is a step-up transformer which converts the AC current into higher voltage current now. And from each transformer, you will be having four wires. Okay. Three phase, three wires, and one neutral. It is also called as the ground wire. So, four wires will be coming out from each of the transformer now. Okay. So, power lines, that is nothing but four lines comes out of every power plant. Three phases, power being produced simultaneously, plus a neutral or a ground common to all three will be there now. So, that is how the electrical power is generated now. Now, coming back to here now. After the rotation of the shaft, the water that is being led from the penstock, it has to go out. So from how it will go out? It will go from this end. This is called as the draft tube. What is draft tube? It is nothing but enlarged pipe under suction pressure. That means suction pressure means negative pressure. That means it is always submerged in water. The exit is always submerged in water now. So why it should be submerged? What is the function of draft tube? We will look it in the next classes. Let us not look into it. So that means after the turbine, after the turbine rotation is over, the water that is being made to rotate the turbine will flow out of it by means of a draft tube now. By means of a draft tube. This is there only when it is a reaction turbine. If it is a reaction turbine, what is a reaction turbine? You don't know now at present. That also you don't know. So therefore, I will not much go through it. In the case of reaction turbine, in the case of reaction turbine, you will be having draft tube. But in the case of impulse turbine, what is impulse turbine also? You don't know at present. However, you just know it now. In the case of impulse turbine, the water will lead to tail race at atmospheric pressure. At atmospheric pressure. That means you will not be having the draft tube. You will not be having the draft tube. Just it will flow through the atmospheric pressure now. Okay. So that is there now. So that is called as the tail race. This portion is called as the tail race. So what is tail race? So after utilization of the water, from the turbine, the water has to be led back to the river, which we have already shown you in the first slide only. The water has to be led back to the tail race, which I have already written here now. This is the tail race. I have written here now. This is the tail race. After the water utilization in the turbine happens, the water is to be traced back to the river proper. That is called as the tail race now. It may lead through a canal. It may lead through a canal, a concrete canal, or directly what you are seeing, it may directly lead to the river proper now. So it is an open channel. It is an open channel made up of reinforced concrete lining that is there, because the large quantity of velocity will be there now. Its function is to carry the water discharge from the turbine after the power is being produced. That's what it is being written here now. In case of reaction turbine, as I told you, a draft tube will be there. It is airtight. It works under suction pressure. And it extends to the tail race. And the draft tube is completely submerged in water. And hence it is called as a draft tube, which will be leading to the tail race proper now. Only in the case of reaction turbine, it works under suction pressure. Otherwise, in the case of impulse turbine, it will be working under atmospheric pressure now. So these are all the components of hydraulic turbine. So when we go through the previous question paper, this is one of the questions I could see. Draw a neat sketch of hydroelectric power plant. Mention the functions of each of the component. So it is being asked now. So I think you should be in a position to write the various functions and the various components. So the various components that you may have to say, various component that you may have to show, or nothing but what I showed you already. They are the four-bay intake structure, penstock, four-bay intake structure, penstock, surge chamber, hydraulic turbine, power hose, draft tube and tail race. These are the various components of hydraulic turbine. The functions you have to tell why each of these are being there in the hydropower plant. I think we have discussed in detail. We are justified with we could know what are the components of hydroelectric power plant, which was being discussed. The components of the hydroelectric power plant we could know at the end of this class now. Okay, so we'll be knowing the types of turbines and their classification in the next classes. So we shall stop today for this class. In the next class, we'll be looking into the second part of the turbines, the various losses, efficiencies, all the things are to be discussed, because the syllabus is the heads and efficiencies. We will look into it in the next class. Thank you for today.